Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an IC695ALG608. And what we're going to be talking about is how to test the device, how to configure it with Prophecy Machine Edition, some troubleshooting, and some of the features about the device itself. So in front of you, you can see that I have the ALG608 powered up. I have green light in module OK, field status terminal block. If you have a red light under module OK or no light at all, that usually means that there's something definitely wrong with the ALG608, and you likely wouldn't be able to follow this test, and it would probably need replacement or repair. Okay, I'm just going to take this terminal block off for a moment, just so you guys can see. This is an IC694TBB032. Okay. Also, you can get a 132 depending on your wiring needs, how much wiring. But when the terminal, this high density terminal strip is put into place and the lever's in the upright position, you guys should have field status and a terminal block green lights indicating that this is completely fastened to the ALG and it's making connection to the terminals. I'm currently using for this test an IC695 PSA040 power supply, IC695 CPU320 processor, and an IC695 ETM001 Ethernet connection, which I'm connected to now. And this is all in an IC695 CHS007 7 slot rack. You can also use a 012 or a 016, which would be fine. Okay, so now that I do have the device powered up and I do have the green lights, I'm ready to go over to Prophecy Machine Edition and configure it. All right. Now, a couple things before I do configure it I wanted to mention about this particular device is that this measures voltage from negative 10 to positive 10 volts DC. It measures current capable of 0 to 20 milliamps DC also. And it also has a feature in which you can choose differential input, in which you would have four inputs to use, or single-ended input, in which you're able to use all eight channels. Okay. So what I'm going to do is in Prophecy Machine Edition, I have the same hardware configuration that I mentioned before, the same rack power supply is using slots 0 and 1, CPU using slots 2 and 3, and the ETM using slot number 4. Leaves me with slot number 5, so I'm going to either double click or right click and add module. This is an analog input, and as I mentioned, it's the ALG608. And some configuration is going to be required. So, as I mentioned before, there's a 4 input or an 8 input. We're going to do the 8 input to start. This is the single-ended input mode, analog input mode, and this can be edited here. Now, if you did, for example, want to use the 4-channel differential, you just click here, and you can see it reduces to 4 channels. But let's begin with the 8 channels, and I'm just going to configure the first 4 channels as all the channels will be tested the same in your application. Voltage current automatically goes over to negative 10 to positive 10 volts DC, and I'm going to switch to 16-bit integer. All right, so we're going to stick with the default voltage DC, enable the circuit, 16. All right, so we'll use these 4 channels just as an example to start. And now, I've toggled it online, so I'm connected up to the processor, and I'm in program mode. If I look down below, it's in programmer mode. Stop, that means that the processor is not in run mode, and disabled means that the inputs and outputs are disabled. Configuration is not equal because it was handling a different task before we've asked it to do this. So we're going to go to target, online commands, clear. And we're going to clear controller and I/O fault table since we're asking it to do something different. That'll keep us from getting hung up when we do the download. Next, we're going to hit download and start active target. Hardware configuration and motion and logic. Top two selections is all I'm going to select to download to the controller. I don't need to write anything to permanent flash memory. It's just a test to make sure that the device is working properly. And we're going to enable the outputs. At this point, you should be in run mode with configuration and logic both equal and the inputs and outputs enabled. So if for some reason you're not in this position right here, you're not as far along, look at your feedback zone. Make sure that you don't have any errors that are listed here that could be holding you up. And if that doesn't help, you can go to Target and go to Diagnostics, and your info viewer screen will turn into a fault table viewer. All right, and it'll list if there are any faults down below. So we're configured for the first four channels. We're gonna go to default tables, analog input. All right, and we'll enter, what I'm gonna do in this particular case is I'm using a 3-volt battery, which has a constant amount of 3 volts that are coming out of it. And the reason I'm doing that is because I want a energy source that is somewhere in between my values that I have chosen. So I'm about a third of the way through, I'm at 3 volts DC. And the wiring diagram I'm going to be using, of course, is going to be the single-ended wiring diagram. You get two wiring cards with this particular device, one for differential, one for 8-channel single-ended. And in this particular case, what you're going to do is touch the negative probe to the common, which is number 5, and channel number 1 is at screw number 1. Channel 2 is at screw number 2, and so on. And I keep getting a value of about 1700, which is accurate. It may fluctuate a little bit until it's able to stabilize. If you just hold it on there longer, it will stabilize. So a few things I'm looking for on each channel, and this is going to be the same for milliamps, differential input. Number one, I look for activity on the channel, that the channel has a response to me probing the channel. If there was no response at all, obviously there's a problem with this analog card, but in my particular case, I'm getting good readings. I'm looking for a stable reading, a reading that's not fluctuating. And of course, if all of my scaling is the same in each channel I'm testing, which in my case it is, I haven't changed the scaling, each reading should be about the same value, okay? The next thing you're gonna do, which is a slightly different wiring, a different placement of my probes. I'm going to go in, hit stop, go to my four channels again. Now I'm going to switch over to 4 to 20 milliamps. All right, you can use 0 to 20 milliamps, but in my particular case, I'm using a 4 to 20 milliamp generator, a 4 to 20 milliamp DC generator. Okay. I'm going to go back to Target. We're asking it to do something different. Clear. Our controller and IO fault tables. And we don't get hung up. And download and run. Same thing, hardware configuration, motion, and logic. Okay. And let's turn it on. Now down below, my status is the same as it was before. Run enabled, configuration equal, logic equal. That's what you should be at. And my configuration is different, okay? So we're gonna be testing milliamps now. We'll switch back over to our analog input table. And I'm going to start probing these channels. Now, I don't know if you guys are able to see this, but there it does require that you have some jumpers in place. Now, I refer to the manual, which is GFK2372G. Which you can also find, it does come with the device, but if you don't have it anymore, you can always find it on your GEIPsupport.com. You just put in on GFK-2372G. And on pages 5 and 6 gives you the wiring diagrams for single-ended mode, 8-channel, and differential mode, 4-channel, and the proper jumpers that are involved. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place my negative terminal on 19 and positive terminal on 1. And I'm using a full 20 milliamps, which is about what I'm getting right now. And I can dial down the output and dial it back up. Okay. Channel 2. I can dial it around. I can see it moving and then stabilizing once I settle. Okay. Channel 4. Again, the same applies for all 8 channels, but just to make the video short enough for you guys to get a very good idea of what I'm doing and how I'm testing it. Another thing that I wanted to mention, of course, is that with milliamps, what I like about this generator is I'm able to dial up and down the amount of milliamps that I'm generating. And the reason that's good is because I typically see failed cards in the field where as soon as you probe it with any value whatsoever, it gives a full 20 milliamps, which is incorrect. It should have some range and resolution. It should have activity on the channel, as I mentioned before, and it should have some stability. It shouldn't be fluctuating. Now, we're going to stop it, go back to our ALG608 and our settings. We're going to ask it to do differential mode, and you're going to see 4 of these channels drop off. All right, so now we have channels 1 through 4. And since we already have these channels configured at 4 to 20 milliamp, we're going to go ahead with that. And we're going to clear controller, IO fault table, okay, yes. Now in this particular case, there's a lot of jumpers that are required for this particular test. So I'm just going to use the first channel to give you guys an example of how you would test a channel under differential input and how it would go for the rest of the channels. Okay. And I'm going to do that by, I have a jumper that's jumped from 2 to 19. Okay. It's kind of a little bit diagonally jumped here. I'm going to tighten that on. Again, that's 2 to 19. And we're going to download and run this. Okay, same procedure. We're in run mode again. We go to analog input. Now I've only activated channel 1 as far as the jumper is concerned. Okay, you would need jumpers on the other 3 channels in order to test all 4 channels. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to probe. Once it's jumpered from 2 to 19, from the left-hand side to the right-hand side of this terminal block, I'm going to place my probes on numbers 1 and 2, positive on 1, negative on 2. All right, now I have my value, and I can dial it down just to make sure it's not giving me a false reading, and I can dial it back up, and I can stop, and it's pretty stable at 19.96465. Okay, so I'm satisfied with that. In the event that you guys are testing, of course, your differential inputs, you would need to jumper across diagonally as it's indicated in the manual. All right. Now, in order to test voltage, I'm just going to simply remove that jumper. I'm going to stop the controller. Go to my settings. And we're going to switch over to, we could just do 0 to 10. Simple enough. All right. Again, clear. Controller IO fault table. It's a step you don't want to skip. Download and run. Same procedure over and over again. Okay, at this point you should be in run mode if you're able to follow that properly. We're going to go back to our analog input table. And we want to, of course, test the values that we get here. Okay, so again, differential input using a 3-volt battery. Positive on one, negative on two. Okay. We're getting a value. 3 and 4 is channel 2. Alright. 6 and 7, channel 3. 8 and 9, channel 4. Okay. Now I am using a terminal strip that has excessive amount of jumpers on the right hand side, which is giving me a value at address number 1 that wouldn't normally be there, but this is just for to simplify the testing procedure. So in the event that you guys have any problems with this unit, if the module OK light is not on, as I said before, or if it's red, if you're not getting any green lights here, that would usually indicate that there's a problem from the start with this device, with this analog card, would need repair or replacement. If any of the channels are unable to give you a value, or if the value is unstable or incorrect, again, it would need replacement or repair. And the ALG608 is something that we do commonly repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same-day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.